up, SVG Squad? My name's Brandon. I'm a new addition to the team. I'm just, like, right now, I'm in school in San Diego. So I don't have a lot of time to shoot videos and record, but luckily, I mean, I have some time and I go to the gym every day. So when I have some friends there to help me get some good shots, I try to get those. Right now, I'm actually in a caloric surplus, so I'm fucking bulking right now. And it's great. I get to focus on growing muscle and then gaining as much strength as possible. This workout I'm going to show you guys today is a chest and biceps workout. It's a little different. People kind of think it's unorthodox, which it is. I mean, most people do chest with tries, biceps, and back. But for some reason, I think that this way for me works better. It allows me to get the most out of my accessory work after my main lifts, like when I bench. If I'm going to try to do tries, I don't feel the pump as well. I don't feel the connection to my mind and my mind to muscle connection nearly enough. So I do this just to compensate for that. It really doesn't help me like in overall in training, but it helps me psychologically. So it helps me train better. It doesn't help me grow any faster, to simplify what I just said. So yeah, I started off with a bench. I do a simple 5x5, but this one I did 5x4. Just to change it up a little bit. I wanted to go a little heavier and still get some volume. I should have added a couple more sets, but at the time I wasn't really thinking about it. I warmed up. I took 2 warm-up sets. I did about 10 reps with 135 pounds. It was nice and quick. In the last few, I was like, oh, I'm going to slow it down, get that eccentric part of the motion of the bench press, and really focus on that to get the blood flowing, keep my muscles saturated with the blood, and keep myself safe. Second set, I went up to 165, did 8 reps of that. Took a little bit of more of a rest, probably about 3 minutes between that and my working sets. So I had 5 working sets of 4 reps each. Each was at 185. For the first set, man, it felt really good. I was just going in on there. Excuse me. I was just going to town on that one. It was really, really smooth. Second one, it was not as good, but wasn't bad. The last rep was a little bit harder. You can tell it's like a little more grindy compared to the first 3. But my third set, I think that one was my best one. I was just smooth for all 4. I had the best mental connection there, I guess. I don't know. My mindset. There you go. Well, yeah, my mindset was definitely the best. For my fourth set, I went beltless. The reason why I wear a belt when I bench isn't really to help me improve my lifts, although I know it can. It's mostly just a psychological boost for me. It doesn't really do anything when I'm benching, unless I'm going for PRs. Then it obviously does. It helps me brace and but for these sets, it was just psychological. And once I got finished with that, or the first 3, I was like, you know what, fuck it, I'm going without the belt. Fourth set was it was a little harder. I mean, the last rep was pretty rough, as well as it was the same in the fifth set too. The first 3 were okay. The third one was actually a little harder, and the fourth one was way more grindy. Like, I was just like grinding the crap out of that one. After that, I did some accessory work, just some incline press. So I did 3 sets of that, dumbbells, 60 pounds each. So I think there's only 2 sets shown in the video because I had some technical difficulties. My camera just ran out of memory out of nowhere, and it just started shooting like 1-second videos. It was ridiculous. It literally said it was recording, and I looked to go check, and then it's like, nope, none of them saved. So I only got a couple of those for you guys. After I noticed that, I deleted more videos so I could record the rest of my workout. So when I'm doing the incline press, yeah, I'm going pretty slow, trying to keep in that keep the tension in my upper chest, really squeeze the life out of the muscles, and get the most out of each set. Okay, after I did those 2 sets, I mean, trying to look beast with my little hood on in that second clip of me doing it. But after I was done with that, I did some cable flies. I did 4 sets, and there was no rep range. It was just until I felt pumped out. There's no footage of that when I'm in the video, but same thing happened. My camera just lost memory, even though I deleted like a ton of crap. Unfortunately that happened, but well, I'll make sure it doesn't happen next time. After that, I did arms, well, biceps. I started off with standing barbell curls. I did 3 by 8 for the first 2 sets, and then for the last set, I did 3 by 7, and this was all with 80 pounds. I was really focusing on just squeezing in the concentric portion of the lift, and then focusing on the eccentric portion of the set. So I really just stretch out the muscle, and then there's a lot of the studies but showing that that is what helps you build muscle and gain muscle. And then there's rope hammer curls. That one I did for 3 sets. There was no rep range for that one either. That one is just, well, there is a rep range. It's more like 10 plus, and then pump if you get the pump. Once you feel it, and you're good. And then as a finisher, I did seated curls, 2 sets until failure, and I did that with, I believe, either 30 or 35 pound dumbbells. And yeah, I think that was it. I'm pretty excited to keep bulking. I've decided that, hey, I'm gonna probably bulk for the next year, and that's mainly just to put on some decent size because I'm trying to compete in a men's physique competition. Super motivated, stick to the diet. It's a little more lenient than when you're cutting, obviously, but we'll freaking see, because I just don't want to get fat. I might get fat. But let's see, we try to keep the body fat as low as possible and gain as much muscle as possible. Yeah, so I'm just gonna get to it. Let you guys enjoy the rest of the video. I'm super excited. Peace, SVG Squad.
Metro, I don't trust you, I'm gonna shoot you.